Hello, cuties. A very good morning. Have a good day. A warm welcome to IDL and Adarsh Vidyalaya Matriculation School online class. Class 2nd standard, subject computer science, session 2.
Today we are going to learn about simple concept. Cuties, all of you ready? Okay. Today's topic is input and output devices. First of all, what is meant by output and what is meant by input? Students, listen carefully. Input means taking in. Input means taking in. Output means giving out. Output means giving out. This is a simple concept. First of all, understand this. Okay, I repeat again. Input means taking in and output means giving out. Okay? Students, just see this figure. What do you understand? Okay, don't worry. I will tell. When you water the plant, here that is an input and it results in growth of the plant. Here, growth of the plant, that is an output. I repeat again. Listen carefully. When you water the plant, here that is an input and it results in growth of the plant, here that is an output. So, same like that, even in computer, we have input and output devices. When we use it in the context of a computer system, these words are defined from the computer's perspective. Okay? For example, it takes in what we type on the keyboard, we move the mouse, okay? And the computer shows us the position with the cursor. These are the examples of input devices. The computer shows us a movie on the monitor. It plays music through the speakers, okay? First of all, we are going to learn about input devices. Input devices allows us to send information to the CPU and tell the computer what to do. Okay? There are several ways to get new information or input into a computer. The two most common ways are the keyboard and the mouse. Okay? Let us see one by one.
Students, what is this? You know already, because previous session we learned about keyboard. Right. Okay. As you see in figure, the keyboard has keys for characters, that is letters, numbers, punctuation marks and special commands. Okay. Pressing the keys tells the computer what to do or what to write. Okay. This figure shows mouse. As you see, it has a special ball that allows you to roll it around a pad or a desk. Okay? And move the cursor around a screen. For example, just as you read moving a finger on the book, the computer shows the cursor. By clicking on the buttons on the mouse, you give the computer direction on what to do. Okay? Okay, students, you learned about input devices. Next, we are going to learn about output devices. What is output? Output to transfer data from the computer to device that allows you to see, hear, or feel it. You already know output means giving out. And output devices receive information from the CPU and translate it into sounds or images we can understand. Okay? And output devices display information in that you can understand. Okay, students, I hope you understand what is output device. Next, we are going to learn about most commonly used output devices. And most commonly used output devices are monitor, speaker, and printer. Okay, students, let us see one by one. Okay? The most common output device is a monitor. As you see in figure, it looks a lot like a TV, okay, and has the computer screen. The monitor allows you to see what you and the computers are doing together, okay. And some other output devices are speakers and printer. Speakers are output devices that allow you to hear sound from your computer, okay. There are usually two of them and they come in various size. Next, a printer is another common part of a computer system. It takes what you see on the computer screen and prints it on paper. Okay, I hope all of you understand this printer. Students, just take a minute and listen carefully. Okay? This figure shows one of the cycle formation method of both input and output devices. Okay? Here, user means we are the user. Okay? If we give a data to the computer after the process, here that is an input. Once the process is over, user get the information. Here, that is an output. Okay? All of you understand? Hope, I think all of you understand this cycle formation method. Okay, dears, I hope all of you understand about input and output devices and you enjoyed the session. Next, let us move to the homework of today's session. First of all, I read out the questions. First one, define input devices. Second one, define output devices. Third one, input means DAS. Fourth one, output means DAS. Okay, students, first of all, you take your note and write down your homework. See you next session. Thank you all.